What's up, SigmaF users? Welcome to the new post-firmware 5.0 world. If you don't already know, Sigma released FP and FPL's newest firmware last week. It's got a bunch of new stuff. If you want to check out all of them, click on this video, link in the description below. But this video is about Sigma FP's new super useful exposure level monitoring tool, namely the EL zone. FP and FPL are the first mirrorless cameras to get this function. Firstly, I'm going to briefly talk about what EL zone is and put it in perspective with the standard false colors that we're already used to. Secondly, I'll show you the footage of EL zone from each ISO. I recorded the FP screen on Ninja 5 in ProRes LT quality. Thirdly, we're going to talk about the accuracy of EL zone, primarily in the highlight clipping range, since that's where it's trickiest. EL zone is a type of false colors. Essentially, the false colors assigns different colors to areas of different brightness levels. The false colors that we're used to have a percent IRE scale. This is based on voltage readings of the signal that the camera gets, and they are linear, not logarithmic. Brightness, which is luminance perceived by the eye, and f-stops are logarithmic. Which means that the IRE units don't precisely translate and are consistent with f-stop changes. The colors or hues are arbitrarily assigned by the manufacturer of the display or camera that has this option. So for example, a Thomas false color scheme and numbers of hues is different from Blackmagic's or Sigma's. We've got a bite-sized video on false colors if you want to know a bit more about how they work in practice. I'm currently working on a more detailed technical video on this topic. I'll post the link in the description below when it's up. Sigma's false color scale tells you that the 18% gray is represented with green. This is the average zero EV spot. It is then up to you to approximate how much underexposed or overexposed your other elements from the frame are with respect to this point. It is also not very accurate when it comes to lighting different skin tones. EL zone addresses this problem with accurate skin tone exposure as well as the previous problem that was mentioned, the IRE to f-stop approximation. The EL zone system was introduced by cinematographer Ed Lachman ASC, who had developed it for nearly 30 years before patenting it and talking to Panasonic, which incorporated it in their Varicams. It was offered to users through a firmware update on April 1st, 2021. The system uses a color code where hues correspond to different f-stops. 0 EV is the midpoint, so here the 18% or middle gray is actually a gray hue, finally. The other exposure values are marked with respect to 0 EV, the same notation that you have for your camera's exposure meter. Another good thing is that immediately to the left and to the right, you've got separate hues for half f-stops. That half a stop there is important when trying to decide the optimal exposure for skin tone. Overblown highlights are shown in white, and car shadows in black, which I find easy to remember in terms of color coding. The downside of this system is that it doesn't warn you where the highlight clipping point is for each ISO. Before going on to our test footage, this is from the official Sigma YouTube channel. I'm throwing the dynamic range chart here too. So we've got ISO 100, which clips at +3 EV. False colors looks good. Now, the EL zone on the other hand though, tells us that this middle clipped bit here is +3 EV. There's no way the exposure difference between here at +1 f-stop and here in the clipped bit is only 2 f-stops, is there? According to the scale, the middle bit here should be white, but maybe I'm wrong and it's actually exposed at +3 EV. Test footage time. EL zone for ISO 100 starts off dodgy. For +5 EV and +4 EV, it shows the color corresponding to +3 EV. It's accurate from +3 EV downwards. For ISO 200, we get the same for ISO 100. It's good from +3 EV downwards. for ISO 400. It's okay from +5 EV downwards. ISO 800, it's good on the whole range. ISO 1600, it's also good on the whole range. ISO 3200, it's okay from +5 EV downwards. ISO 6400 is good across the board as well. This is what we looked at. Remember that the EL zone is only inaccurate in the highest bits of overexposure for each ISO, so it's okay once you go down from there. If we pull up the dynamic range here, we can see that with the exception of ISO 200, the EL zone is accurate up to the highlight clipping range for each ISO, which makes sense because the clipping EV level for each ISO is where the color shown for the EL level stops as well. For example, the color corresponding to the highest EV level in the picture here is +3, here it's +5. If I can sort of make up an explanation in my mind as to why the mapping for EL zone can't distinguish anything after the clipping point for each ISO, I can't explain at all why ISO 200 produces the same result as ISO 100 when the color here should be red since its clipping point is +4 EV. All in all, I think EL zone is a good idea, and I'm definitely going to be using it for exposing a subject's face. It should have no issues if I'm in a controlled setting indoors. However, if I'm outside and I'm concerned about blown highlights, the only way I see around this issue is to first use the standard false colors to check out if anything I need is in the red zone, roughly correct the exposure based on that, and then switch to EL zone and finesse the exposure for my subject. It's a pretty cumbersome process. As a final note, I think Sigma should have added a written note that came with the EL zone update, warning about it not providing accurate monitoring if your exposure is higher than the clipping point for each ISO.